Did you know that next week is Historic Garden Week here in the Old Dominion, and the folks from the Lynchburg Garden Club are not to be outdone, so they've teamed up with several other clubs in the region, and they've put together an amazing event coming up this Tuesday. Here to tell us all about it, we have Robin Johnson and Betty Bybee. Thank you, ladies, for joining us.
Thank you.
I couldn't wait to talk about this because I love this time of the year, and I'm so into flowers and gardening and that kind of thing, which, by the way, you brought some lovelies to have on the set. But let's start with sort of localizing it maybe a little bit. First, let's talk about the state. What is Historic Garden Week in general?
Well, the Garden Club of Virginia started in 1929. A few garden clubs decided that Kenmore in Fredericksburg was in bad disrepair and neglected, so they decided to put on a garden and house tour to raise funds.
Okay.
And it was such a huge success that it went statewide. So this is our 79th year.
Wow.
The Garden Club of Virginia is headquartered in Richmond.
Okay.
And there are 78 clubs.
Give or take.
Yeah. Is that right? Over the Commonwealth. And the first week of, or the last week of April, every year, we have the largest house and garden tour in the nation.
Wow. Well, I was fascinated when I first heard about it. I had not heard about this until, you know, getting ready to do this segment. So how will Lynchburg be celebrating? You're not to be outdone, so you're going to have your own sort of home and garden tour, if you will. Talk about that.
Yeah, and our focus this year is Poplar Forest and historic gardens.
Okay.
Because Poplar Forest will benefit from the funds that we raise.
Right, right.
They will be working on renovating Jefferson's gardens that they had there. So that will be open. There will be a Jefferson in Bloom flower show in the house, which will depict his life in flowers. Then they will have tours around Poplar Forest showing you the renovation of the garden, the restoration, I
right,
should say.
Right, right.
And then Point of Honor will be our headquarters.
Okay.
And there'll be a lot of things going on at Point of Honor. Then we have four homes that are open, two on Cabell Street and two on Mountain Laurel Drive.
Okay, because that's what I want to get people to understand is this is kind of a tour where there's several different homes open and on display.
Yes.
With their indoors and gardening and that kind of thing. And so folks are kind of stopping in at different points to really take in the beauty of it all, right?
Right.
And the process, it's a fundraiser. And so that's pretty much the whole effort is you're trying to make it a fundraiser.
Absolutely.
But also folks really get to see some beautiful homes in great locations. So that's
and lots of ideas for their garden as well as their home. So it's a very very fun event for many people.
And like you were telling me yesterday, so Poplar Forest is the recipient this year, but you choose every year a different location to benefit from the event.
There's a committee at the state level, the Restoration Committee, and they do choose recipients. And there's about 40 over the state, all over the state of Virginia,
wow,
that we have helped historic gardens and grounds to for their benefit.
Sure. And so we were lucky this year to have Poplar Forest
so
just
lucky
down the road.
Mm-hmm.
They have got to be loving you guys, I'm sure.
Well, we're excited too.
Well, we're going to have the information up in just a second, and people will be able to know kind of to go about it. But what are the kinds of things that we can expect to see? Again, there's going to be four or five homes, locations?
Four homes.
Okay.
One of them is a bed and breakfast on Cabell Street, and
awesome,
they are certified as a green bed and breakfast. And so that will be nice to see the conservation that's going on there, as well as two homes on Mountain Laurel.
Right.
One is a newer home and one is a restored home.
And you say these are from walking distance from each other, right?
The Cabell Street, just a block away, and right down from Point of Honor, and then on Mountain Laurel across the street from each other. So
and
parking
again,
should not be a problem.
Parking will not be a problem. That's great. So really, it's great that people are opening up their homes and their gardens. I mean, that's a little intrusive, but it's they must really believe in this cause to do that.
We really appreciate it, too.
All right. Well, let's show the information, get it up there. Thank you, ladies, so much for being here. Just real quick, so Historic Garden Week runs from the 21st through the 28th, and that is the website there for the whole week. And then the Garden Day in Lynchburg is Tuesday, April 24th, 10 to 6. There's the phone number there. And then tickets from $8 all the way to $25. And there are the locations where you can pick up those tickets. And that's going to be a great event. Looking forward to that. Thank you, ladies.